I'm free. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
the crucifixion. Therefore, it was at Pentecost, as Jesus promised, when they would receive the Holy Spirit. Some of you might be wondering, what is the Holy Spirit? Everyone is excited about it here this morning. And why did it come? The Holy Spirit is the mysterious power or presence of God in individuals, inspiring and empowering them with qualities they would not otherwise possess. The term spirit in Hebrew is translated as ruah, meaning breath. Therefore, the Holy Spirit can be described as the breath of God. It is that breath of God that gives you life. It is that breath of God that gives you power. It is that breath of God that gives you your being. And we're not talking ordinary power, but we're talking God's power. We're talking dunamis power. God's power is the power to see hope in the midst of despair.
Joel, and we know that God always keeps his promise. I know.
pour out his spirit on everyone. But why in the form of fire? Why tongues of fire? Tongues symbolize speech and the communication of the gospel. Fire signifies God's purifying presence, burning away the undesirable elements of our lives and setting our hearts aflame to ignite the lives of others. On Mount Sinai, God confirmed the validity of Old Testament law with fire from heaven. At Pentecost, God confirmed the validity of the Holy Spirit's ministry by sending fire.
When you're fired up for Jesus, folk will tell you,
when you fired up for Jesus, you can't help tell somebody. But every now and then, some of us get like Jeremiah. We get so discouraged. We get so upset. We get so mad.
The psalmist said, I was glad when they said, As long as